Welcome back to The Plug. I'm Penny Kaps Dukakis.
And I'm Olivia Deem, and we're here with...
Jake Smith, or Legit Smitty.
Where did your name come from? Where did Legit Smitty come from?
So when I was in middle school, you know, Instagram begins.
Oh, no.
And the search for an Instagram handle begins at the same time there. And I think I tried to like start giving myself a nickname because I was so upset with the fact that there were like two or three other kids I knew named Jake Smith. And I just felt really boxed in and unoriginal. And I was like, I have to rename myself. And I will say I've thought many times about changing it. A lot of friends and fans have given me backlash. We have decided as a whole to not change any names as of right now.
There you have it.
Screw peer pressure.
Yeah, right? What?
The pandemic really has led to pretty much the extinction of live music for a period. But now as things are opening up, I know you played some live shows at the Cookery. And just being back in Nashville, what is it like to like play shows and experience live music again?
It's definitely still kind of depressing. But it's fun to have something rather than nothing. We got to play a show at the Cookery, it's a little local coffee shop, and that was very stripped back, acoustic. Obviously, the preference is a real live show, and I think we're all looking forward to the day when that comes back.
The EP came out on February 5th, right? So what can you tell us about the process of making Goodwill Steeple?
I should have had Goodwill Steeple done probably 4 months sooner than I did, but I chose to really dwell on a lot of very tiny nitpicky things. I basically like started writing the songs about 6 months ago while I was at home, right kind of when COVID hit. I was one of the people that took COVID as an opportunity to like lean into my emotions.
Yeah, I remember when Feeling Rough came out a couple weeks ago and then just hearing it all together. Just could you explain the meaning and the story that kind of goes along through Goodwill Steeple?
The story, I guess, wasn't really anything more than just kind of an outcry and saying like, wow, I'm going through life, I'm getting older. It's just kind of like a whiny EP, honestly. It's just a lot of me whining and being like, tracks like Goodwill Steeple are like, okay, let's look at these good times and be thankful for them. But a lot of the EP is just kind of like, why? Like, why is this the way it is? And like growing up and getting older. And
on a little bit different of a note, let's talk about everyone's favorite non-label label. What in the world is Holy Moly Records?
Ha, Holy Moly Records in its origin was just kind of a way for us to put a name on the things we were creating, me and my friends. It's just kind of a roof over the heads of me and my independent artist friends, and a way for us to find strength in numbers. And we make, you know, merchandise and things like that, and try to promote good messages and, you know, positivity and creativity in all circles.
So now that the EP is out, what's kind of next music-wise for you?
Who? Oh. What do I say? I know, but I don't know if I can say. It's just gonna be another project. That's all I'll say right now. Hopefully longer format is what I'm pushing for. There's just a bunch of stuff that we plan to do this year.
All right, Jake, it was so great having you on the show. And like you said, everyone go check out Goodwill Steeple and all the other artists on Holy Moly Records. For The Plug, this is Penny Kapadoukakis.
And Olivia Deem. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Jake.
Peace.